So the millennials who shop are the ones who are going to be driving the shopping experience and the retail. And they will be the peers for any consumption that happens within a household. That's one trend I see. The second trend is from shopping being a very personal thing, it's becoming more social. People are sharing the shopping experiences on the social networks. And that's been now connected through e-commerce and otherwise, that you did this and everybody in your peer group, your friend circle, your family should know about it. The third I see is that from the generation of everybody trying to discount each other, I think it's getting back to a little more matured stage where discounts are not just the thing that everybody wants. I think they're looking at far more than discounts now. So there is no way that the customer that we have out there is not connected. There is, you know, there would be probably not an iota of person who's not connected. They're always connected. As an experience business, it's a physical store business. And one thing for sure happens, because being a very service-oriented business, we don't have product as much, that any experience, good or bad, is shared immediately. So we are always looking at a mirror. And every day in the morning, I get up and I actually go through all the reviews that come in. And there's always that, you know, that little pressure on the heart where saying, you know, I hope things went, you know, well. So it's kind of really connected and always online. I think equally both. They both serve different purposes. At the end of the day, it's a global market today. Everybody is traveling. Everybody, there's a huge amount of rub off that the international brands bring. Having said that, whether it's in product or service, you know, we all experience all kinds. So we could probably go to, in relevant to, you know, a beverage market, we would love to go to a Starbucks. At the same time, we'd love to go to a chai place too. So I think both will complement each other. From a footprint point of view, yes, because the footprint tier 2 and 3 from the geography point of view would be obviously larger than tier 1, because tier 1 is kind of relegated towards the 7 or 8 different metros. From a business perspective, I think the metros, because in India we always gravitate towards these urbanized cities, and they'll always kind of always be full and keep getting more population. So I don't think the sale or the component will go down. Also, when you come into an urban city, your aspiration levels are different, and I think you end up consuming more. I would probably say either or, they're not going to actually, you know, they both would be different in their own ways, but I don't think tier 2 and 3 can actually take over tier 1. Incredible.